and had it produced. I saw it, the production, you saw it. And I knew that was the same character that he remembered. And then he ran into the flesh and blood character that he could see 6 years before. So the sixth chapter of the book of John. No one can come unto me unless the Father who is sent me draws him. The last day, I will lift him up. The day will come, and the last day doesn't mean the last day 24 hours. It means the last day of eternity from the day of the grave, and it is your last time around. And you are not on the heel of the cross anymore. And then that last phase comes to an individual. He may have this experience. When you least expect it, no one ever told you about it. And maybe what I tell you now, you'll forget and quickly forget. So when it happens, you will come as a very wonderful prophet's words. Because you have heard nothing that you've heard it from my lips. But now, you don't know about it, you never heard about it, no one told you about it. And one night, or it comes to the day, but in my case, you all to come, and you'll be always in the Lord. And so, you will be suddenly twisted down within yourself. And you your spirit will go. And you'll be clothed in the most glorious body of fire and air. It's like words. It needs no stars, no sun, no moon to illuminate your path. And a heavenly chorus will call your name, whatever your name is. And they will pronounce the name and say, he is risen. But he is risen. But the name, so your name is John. John is risen. John is risen, they repeated. And then this chorus will sing up, the most glorious heavenly chorus will sing, your praise belongs to you, and in this. And then you will come upon a sea of infinite imperfection, human imperfection. The limp, everything is there. The blind, the halt, the limp, everything is conceived, all taking human form. And they're waiting for you, their Redeemer, to redeem them. And as you glide by, you seem to glide by, they bring one who glides from into infinity perfection, to the pathways of imperfect soul. Blind people become those of perfect sight, the deaf hear, the limp, the halt, the river, the all cease to walk their road as you pass by. And when you come to the very end, and the last comes to me, and Father, I call him. Then the same heavenly chorus will exult and ring out, it is finished, the last cry of the cross. And then you, the unfinished business, will be turned here. To complete it, to tell it, maybe to leave it here for a permanent form in the form of a picture, or a story, but you will tell it in a more permanent form. And you yourself are full of experience, because God is as far as you're concerned, that you will tell it for the benefit of others. As freely up as you will. Return here to complete the few remaining years for your 8 years of life. Everyone had to be raised that he would believe. Everyone had to be transformed into perfection. To conform to you that he would have done. And at any moment you are perfect. And so as you walk by, you mold and bend in harmony with the perfection springing within you. And you do it without effort, without taking thought. You are not the conception of life. You are not concerned about these people. You simply walk by knowing in the depth of your soul, it is all perfect. And everyone is shaped and molded in harmony with that perfection springing within you. So you're told now, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will lift all of them unto me. I will show you and transform them. And so no one came save by Father. If I call any, the believer, and then every certain will, I'll bring him ashore. And suddenly I'm broken in victory that's known as 6 years ago. For I am glad and qualified suddenly and bounce upon me. That I've been walking around this past 2 years in the company around and find myself a community that I didn't recognize. Here is a man in my own world, and for 2 years he's been in my life, and there are things with my world, and I didn't recognize my own creation. Well, that's what the verse does all day long. It draws only its own, but doesn't recognize its own creation. No man cometh unto me save thy Father. For my Father and I alone. So if he can come unless my Father bless him, he can't come unless I do it. I am my Father. That's why I'm drawing every being into my world. Good, bad, or good. When I think Jesus, and he passes myself, he's not that you can't trust him. Where in my world do I go back to that moment of mistrust in me when I really can't trust myself? I think I was afraid of my own behavior if given an opportunity. If I could ever get away with it, I might. Now, it may not be allowed to sit down and write the story. I can write the story. I could write your story. But if you are on me, have eyes upon that, don't get it. I might concentrate with pleasure on that that is God will be quite embarrassing to those who love me. I might. If in the past I have ever contemplated that, some wealth of foresight that would come right into my world, I'm going to tell that person right in my world, and I condemn for it. But in condemning him, I'm condemning myself because he is my very self, bearing witness to my own creations. Bearing witness, I told a story here once, many years ago. It was a very intimate story, and I tell it certainly not to bury you over there. But you think I ever felt this way that you can't ever be in this world. Because you're the cause of the guilt of being around you to be in this world. And I tell it because it's not quite possible. And I was severely criticized, by the audience for it, and criticized the following month by the wife of the gentleman who brought me to this town to hear the scene of the lectures. I'm so many criticized, you find the written letters, I can't tell you about them. Many of them are letters I received that are very, very critical of what you said from the platform. I said, I didn't say for any better power than to show everyone that they are the cause of the misbehaviors of others that were condemned. They are the cause of it. And so, I tried to speak to God, but it's not condemnation as a person. I was putting myself, I was the cause of powerless, the cause of my action. And this is the story. I was married and separated for 15 years. Not divorce, and not kind of a separation, no legal separation, but separated. I was married at the age of 18, part of 19, separated at 20. And then for about 15 years, we lived our separate lives, and only saw each other when she was driving me to court for non-payment of alimony. That's the only time I ever saw each other. I always came out of the court with a reduction. Always, not after the argument. So, 7 times before the court and 7 times at the numbers right. The time she knew that I'm not taking any more, there's nothing else to get. There's nothing the next time. And so that was the picture. So I told her, you know, all these things are happening. And one day, I knew I wanted to get married to a certain partner. My daughter, the mother of my daughter. But I had all this entangled personal life. Of separating them. You can't get divorced in New York City, so I'm done, and if I can't go on the world. Therefore, nothing but collusion goes on in the courts, the divorce courts in New York City. So I'm going to be forced upon them because of it. But I can't help you. That's how I got my divorce. And then she was told by a very close, intimate friend of mine that I wanted a divorce and really need to get on top. But my friend didn't want me to get a divorce and marry the girl that I eventually married. So, I thought, well, I've now applied this law, and I've set this law, and I'm happy Thank you.